Set in the newly found commercial village of Rhinoka, Moonlighter takes the player through the adventures of a boy named Will, a young shopkeeper looking to become a hero. Mixing elements of an action RPG, dungeon crawler, and those of a roguelite, Moonlighter sees the players venturing through various different procedurally generated dungeons in search of loot. These dungeons are a result of recent archaeological excavations and are filled with ancient constructs and monsters which are said to guard the most precious relics a human can find. The game does a very wonderful job at introducing the player to the basics of combats and movements, with it starting out nice and easy and progressing to more difficult enemies and room layouts. Along with the tutorial, an old man by the name of Zenon serves as a mentor to Will and helps him grasp the basics of shopkeeping, which includes setting prices for loot you find, knowing how to tell if the price is right, and always warning us about the dangers of the dungeons. These dungeons are procedurally generated and because of this are always unique. Each fight you choose to take or not take can be approached differently, as the room layouts and enemy spawns will always differ. The dungeons once entered have three floors to them, with the last floor culminating in an epic and challenging boss fight. As you're moving through the floors, the enemies will also become progressively more difficult, gaining more health and dealing more damage. But as the difficulty increases, so does the rarity of the sweet and precious loot. These dungeons are also riddled with traps and secret rooms to enter if you're keen enough to find them. They contain special challenges that are some of the most rewarding in the game, especially in the more difficult dungeons. There are various ways to combat the enemies of these perilous dungeons, such as the sword and shield, giant sword, fist weapon, bow and arrow, or my favorite, the spear. Each of these provides a unique way to fight, as well as some advantages and disadvantages. For instance, the spear can outreach most enemies, but lacks the wide sweeps of the giant sword. These weapons, just like other equipable gear, can be upgraded to gain new appearances as well as improve stats. Upgrade parts are also available for weapons, with the player having the choice of going for raw damage or infusing with an element and having slightly lower base damage with the inclusion of the said elements. The stats on armor pieces can be a little bit more complex, with light armor giving fewer bonuses to health but increasing one's speed and mobility. Same can be said about the heavy armor giving loads more health at the cost of the speed. All armor and weapon upgrades are done courtesy of Vulcan's Forge. This is just one of the many purchasable shops that can move into the town of Rhinoka. Once you've accumulated enough money through the sales of your relics and goods found in the dungeons, options to expand your town and your own shop become available. Expanding the town includes bringing other merchants to stay in Rhinoka who will help you along your journey. Along with Vulcan's Forge, you can also contract an alchemist for all your potion and enchantment needs, a retailer to buy goods that you're short on, a banker to invest your money, and a merchant who sells decorations for your shop. Even the decorations in your shop can have a significant impact, because depending on which of the many you choose to display, you can have customers adding extra tip to their purchase, or even having more customers visit your store in one day. Expanding your shop is slightly different, with there also being various new things to purchase, or the expansion of the actual shop to do. Some of the things you can purchase include a fancy new cash register, which entices customers to add a tip to every purchase, and even a comfy new bed, which gives the players temporary health every time they sleep. Expanding the shop gives the players more pedestals to place items on to sell, and more expensive expansions even give the player a shop assistant to help with the sales. Combining some of the shop upgrades with certain decorations for an increased tip after each purchase is highly recommended, as it does stack up and sometimes you'll be so surprised with how much extra you can earn. Although the shop expansions do bring such beneficial things for the player, it sometimes felt like the jump from one upgrade to another was very steep and could have possibly used more levels in between them. Gaining gold in Moonlighter is basically everything, as it lets you purchase upgrades, buy items, use the dungeon pendant and teleporter, and also fund the upgrading of your gear. The pendant and teleporter are the ways to return to town. The pendant is a one-time use, and the teleporter allows players to keep their progress in the dungeon for one trip, but of course at a much higher price than the pendant. Everything in Moonlighter makes you carefully plan what you want to do. Be it from setting a price for your goods that you're selling, approaching a bunch of enemies in a new dungeon, or even choosing what loot to take from the dungeon and what to leave behind, the player will always have to think twice before a decision. Moonlighter is a delightful game that certainly captured my heart the more and more as I continued playing. awesome and unique enemies in each dungeon kept the experience fresh. Constant upkeep of your shop and watching out for thieves during the open time, yes, some people really do try to steal your loot, is quite engaging and does not leave you wanting to go AFK while people buy your things. A rich pool of loot and materials keeps you searching for rarer items to sell or to use to upgrade your gear, and the fantastic visuals and music of the game always set a good mood for the bright and wonderful town of Rhinoka. Overall, Moonlight is a true gem. With a fluent and easy combat system, great dungeon system, unique enemies, and shopkeeping mechanics, the game moves away from the traditional roguelike genre to deliver something fresh and exciting. We here at MWeb Game Zone score Moonlight a 8.5 out of 10. Yeah.